super fun stuff.
Welcome to Super Fun Stuff. Today I have another print and paint video, starring one of the most powerful Marvel characters in existence. This time I didn't put them on the opening picture, but I'll let you take a guess. She is an awesome comic book character, a so-so movie character, and has been empowered by the most powerful cosmic force. I'm sure most of you got it, but it's Jean Grey as the Phoenix. You all probably know of Jean Grey, and at minimum seen the movies of what they've done with her in the Phoenix Force. The movies were very mediocre, but the comics did her justice. To give a quick recap, Jean Grey is a telepathic mutant, and she has a link with a cosmic entity called the Phoenix Force. Usually we see the Phoenix Force as a big fiery bird. In the comics, X-Men were in space and Jean was dying, and the Phoenix Force basically saved her. There's way more to the story than I'm telling you about, but we don't need to go into that right now. Anyways, the Phoenix Force saves her, but now Jean Grey becomes the Phoenix, the all-powerful cosmic force. Phoenix has different versions, green, red, and white, and for the most part, she's crazy. Really bad one minute and good another. She dies, she comes back, there's a lot to the backstory. But in short, the Phoenix is awesome, and I found a great 3D model of her. This model posted by Josh STL Scherer is amazing. If you read the description of the model, it was created by Marcelo Lopez Vieira in conjunction with the group ASS. The models that Josh STL Scherer has posted are very awesome, but unfortunately that modeling group is no more. Another really cool part of this design is how well it fits with the artwork. Here is a drawing in the Phoenix that is almost identical to the 3D model. Really cool stuff. I will have the link below if you want to download it for yourself. So with this model, I decided to create a miniature for the new Marvel Crisis Protocol game. I was a little worried at first because of all the small parts on the model, but you know what? Everything printed perfect. One thing I do warn you about is that it's super easy to break some of the small parts, especially the hair, so definitely handle with care. Since I was going to make my own base, I sliced off the 3D model's base using the plain cut tool Mesh Mixer. It's really easy to use and it's quick. With how delicate this model was, I decided to glue her on the base ahead of time, and I also decided to make and paint the base after she was on it. Of course, I primed everything beforehand. But this is quite different from what I usually do. With the base, I was trying to give a cool effect of the rubble being pushed away by her immense power. I paint the base exactly like how I paint the other print and paint videos. I think I might make a basing video soon. So now we have a finished base and a primer model. First color I pick is yellow. Yellow is one of those colors that goes on thin, so you may have to paint the yellow areas with a good coat of white beforehand. It takes about 2 coats of yellow to get a nice color. Now I decide to paint her face. It's the only skin color she has showing, and I use a basic flesh color for this. And now we start on the green. I take a pretty plain green and mix a little yellow into it to make it a little bit brighter. I like to look at my reference picture to try and get the colors to match the best I can. My green is also a little thin, so I make sure to do 2 thin coats. Now we start the hair. So Jean Grey is normally a redhead, but in a lot of the pictures with the Phoenix, it's too red, like fire truck red. So I plan to tone it down just a little bit. I first apply a dark red, and I'll plan to lay some lighter browns on top. Now we have all of our base colors done. For the fire, I go around just like the yellow and make sure to get a nice flat white. Next, I go around and paint my washes. I use a dark green on the green, a light brown for the yellow, flesh wash for the face, and a red wash for the hair. After that, I decided to paint the Phoenix symbol on her chest. So here's where I start to try something new. Fire is one of those things that can be very difficult to get right. If you saw one of my previous videos, I was trying something like GW's contrast paints, but instead using a glaze medium. Out of curiosity, I decided to try it out for this use case. So I take the yellow and mix it with the glaze medium. I load up my brush pretty heavy and apply it on all the fire areas. I was very skeptical at first, but it turned out amazing, way better than I ever would have thought. To give the added glow effect, I take some white and dry brush the rocks around her. I'm careful not to get it on the fire I just painted. Now I go through and do some highlights. I use a series of lighter greens for the suit and lighter yellows to white for the yellow pieces. It's pretty straightforward highlighting. I base everything off my reference picture. I also add a brown and a lighter reddish brown for highlighting on the hair. Next, I go in and paint the details on the face. I paint eyebrows, glowing eyes, and dark red lips. For the eyes, I add a little more flesh wash underneath to give her that nice contrast. Also, I add a little more wash underneath the cheekbones. Now, I do admit, the lips came out bigger than I anticipated. Lips are one of those things that are hard to get right, especially at this size. But for this model, it looked great, so I decided to go with it rather than start over. Like Bob Ross says, happy little accidents. For the last parts, I apply the same type of glaze medium that I did on the fire before, except I work my way up to orange, then dark red. I keep the white and yellow at the bottom, orange in the middle, and dark red on the top. The glaze really blends in the colors well and takes a lot of the work off your hands. Then to top it all off, I add yellow, orange, and red to the rocks for more glow effect. Same thing like the fire, I work my way from the lighter colors to darker colors. Dry brush makes a quick job of these. And there you have it, Phoenix is all done. This model was a hell of a lot of fun to paint, and I think it turned out perfect in the end. The real winner of the show was the glaze medium fire. It started off as an experiment, but I'll definitely be doing it again. I hope this video was helpful, and I hope you check out that awesome Phoenix model. For my next video, I will be doing another Marvel miniature. This guy is small, but has a huge personality. Thank you to all my patrons and supporters, and thank you for watching.